Hello everybody, today is August 15th, 2020, 10:54 a.m., 73 Fahrenheit, 23 Celsius. I'm in East Hampton right now at the eastern end of Long Island, New York, and I'm going to ride my bicycle to Southampton. First, I'm going to visit an area in Bridgehampton, which is known for $15 million average median price homes for sale. It's pretty incredible, but to get there is a bike ride of around half an hour. I have my navigation on right now. I also did a bike ride of the East Hampton Village, and I covered pretty much all of the main beaches in the area if you'd like to check that video out. This is my first time in the Hamptons. I always wanted to check it out because I've always heard about the stories of the rich coming out here and getting away from everything and having second homes. While it is a nice little area, this is actually not really for me. I kind of feel this area is too quiet for my liking. There's the Clinton Academy Historical Society. Busy road. On my other video of East Hampton, I noticed riding my bicycle coming up the other way, it was very busy as well. Good advantage of a bicycle is you can get past most of this traffic. I do wonder where all these people are going. Definitely not the smoothest roads around here.
Turn right on the New York 27 West State
Route 27. Wow, look at that mobile home there.
Continue on New York 27 West for 4 miles.
4 miles of this, I'll take it. The shoulder looks pretty wide also. Wow, $2.65 for gasoline here for regular. Must be expensive to bring gasoline all the way out here on the eastern end of Long Island. That's what it is. This is known as the Montauk Highway. Montauk is an old name for the Native American Indian tribe that used to be here, the Montauk Indians. There's the Water Authority, Suffolk County. Well, there's a nice little area people can go shop at. It's an antique store. And over here too, waxing, dental care, Elegant John Wines, Red Horse Market. Deer crossing for the next 2 miles. That's expected. Out here, there's plenty of them. Let me tell you, there's a lot of traffic here that I did not expect. It's gonna be tricky trying to make a left if there's this much traffic. I hope it slows up on the way to Southampton. Here's the East Hampton Tennis Club, private. People here think it's too dangerous to cross the road, so they just ride on the opposite side of the road, on the shoulder. A lot of debris over here. Last thing I want is a flat tire. There's a sign here for Cedar Point Park. Might be a state park. I think there's also a Indian reservation somewhere along here too. Daniel's whole road is down there. Funny name for a road. Wow, this place has an airport? Let me tell you, just because you have a car out here does not mean you'll be able to get to places quickly. There's traffic out here on the island. So this is the neighborhood of Winscott, settled in 1670. Older than the United States. And I guess Winscott decided to paint this lane with the bicycle symbols. Lumber store. Rum run at home. Wow, some of those pieces of furniture look so expensive. Probably custom wood and handcrafted, designed perfectly. Here's the pet shop. South Fork Animal Hospital. I'm sure there's a lot of pets out here. Here's another gas station. Let's see how much gasoline is here. I think it says $2.52 for regular. Better than $2.60 something back at Exxon over there. Wow, Levain Bakery. They're in the city also. Probably one of my favorite bakeries around. There's Goldberg's Deli with bagels. I also saw a property for sale. I guess here's where people go and get food and lunch too. The downtown area of East Hampton was rather small. I didn't really see too much options over there. But I have heard that Southampton has the most developed downtown out of the two main Hamptons, that being East Hampton and Southampton. It's the most developed downtown. in the area. I think I should be being instructed to turn left soon. And we get to see the most expensive street in the Hamptons. Average selling price of the homes on that street is $15 million. Let's see if we can see any of them from the public road, or if the hedges are too high and the fences are too deep, or the driveway's too deep, you can't see them. All right, so this is the village of Sagaponack. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. I was supposed to go left on Town Line Road, but this didn't instruct me. Let me make sure, because... You know what? I got no internet. Good thing I saw that, because now I gotta make a left over here, which is kind of daunting to say the least. Let me go back there. And I'll try to go straight from here. I think it'll be better. Crazy. There's so much traffic here, and they don't put a light here or anything. Might be better for me to try to walk it across. So actually, my camera messed up. For some reason, it started a new recording, but it was good that I did that because it gave me time to look at the directions again. And this is called Sayers Path on the south side and Town Line Road on the north side. There's another Town Line Road down the path here, so I was kind of acting suspicious if Google Maps was giving me the right direction, but they were the whole time. But now I gotta cross over this road again, which I'm not looking forward to. Letting me go. A little confusing there. Town Line Road I want to go to is the next one down. I gotta turn left, which is very daunting here. I'm gonna go after this car. Come on, come on, come on. Now I gotta wait. Going.
Continue on Town Line Road for half a mile.
Very quiet around here. Oh wow, half a mile to go before Parsonage Lane, which is the most expensive street in the Hamptons. Does that mean these homes have a half a mile of backyard? Imagine that. It's quite possible they do. Alright, here it is. $15 million and up homes coming up. Let's see if we're able to see any of them.
Turn right onto Parsonage Lane, then you will arrive at your destination. You have arrived.
Right. Definitely a lot of real estate here. I can see why these homes are worth a lot of money if they have an entire farmer's field. So far, not a lot of homes. There's an apple orchard over here. Hey, wow, that's an incredible house. That driveway goes so deep you can't even see what's in there. This one's in contract. This is a very interesting building, unique architecture in this house. It's a charming house. I find it hard to believe that these homes are $15 million and up though. I mean, I would think that the homes right by the water, like where I was earlier at Lily Pond Lane and by the ocean, would fetch the most money. But I guess these homes have a little bit of extra charm to them. Maybe they're more quiet, or they have some more real estate. Who knows? You don't really see too much of anything though because of the hedges. This one you can see though. Wonder how far this Parsonage Lane goes. Here's a house for sale, Douglas Elliman. It's a cute little house. Someone's throwing a lot of stuff in there. Is the African American farmhouse. Alright, this looks like the end of Patchogue Lane, most expensive street in the Hamptons. But now it's time to find my way to the main area of the village of Southampton. Look at that, there's some wild turkeys up there. Alright, let me see where I want to go now. I want to go to the downtown area of Bridgehampton. It's 10 minutes away.
Head north on Sag Main Street toward Parsonage Lane.
Okay, right turn here. Sag Main Street.
Continue on Sag Main Street for 3/4 mile.
Oh, this is nice. Local honey, corn, jams. We've also got wild turkeys here too. Thank you. definitely a little bit windy right now. The wind over here. I see a lot of homes to sell here. All right, I'm gonna make a left here.
Turn left onto New York 27 West, New York State Bicycle Route 27.
I think I may be entering Bridgehampton soon if I'm not here already. Bridgehampton is right between East Hampton and Southampton. How long this traffic light will take. Traffic light is too long. I might even go now.
Continue on New York 27 West for 1 mile.
Hampton, settled in 1656. more traffic building up here. That's such a nice school building, wow. Bridgehampton School. Sag Harbor and Shelter Islands to the right. I've heard that's a very nice town as well. It's right on the coast of Long Island. Wow, I'm already on the Bridgehampton's downtown area already. That was quick. Wow, this is nice. I don't expect to see much in Bridgehampton though, because it is the smaller downtown out of the Hamptons in the area. I thought East Hampton was a little bit small also. There's Starbucks coffee. Got that nice quiet town feel to it. Marina, pop-up store, homemade ice cream. Cool. Smart home, pictures and framing. Sotheby's Realty. Golden Pear Cafe. There's a bunch of people eating outside here. World Thai. Bridgehampton Candy Kitchen. All right, that might be the entire downtown area. Very small. Hopefully Southampton's downtown area does not disappoint. Bridgehampton Inn and Restaurant. Dinner and cocktails to go. There's BNB Bank. Pizza place. Bridgehampton Commons. What's this place all about? Wow. That's a nice little outlet over there. I saw Panera Bread. Dunkin' Donuts inside. It's a Carvel. Looks kind of quiet in there. Armin and Judy Bakery. Whoa, look at that. I think it only takes about 25 minutes or so to get to Southampton from Bridgehampton. Thank you. Berkshire Hathaway, whoa. I didn't know they were out here. That's Warren Buffett's company. There's a local market, but it looks like they're closed today. Thank you. traffic's building up again, which probably means I'm close to the downtown area of Southampton. A lot of trees here. I see a lot of peaches now. Tree ripe peaches. Those look good. Eastland Farms. Also gotta be careful of the road here, because there's dips in the pavement. Welcome to Watermill. I didn't even know there was a neighborhood between Bridgehampton and Southampton. The Hamptons Wine Trail. I don't really see too many grapes being grown though. Most wine, they need grapes. I do know there are a bunch of vineyards around here. There's a Mexican restaurant, Sabrosa. How much is gas here? $2.49, all right. So the further west you go, the less expensive gasoline becomes. Beautiful arrangement of different plants here with the sign in front, Creative Touch Landscaping. That's a perfect advertisement for them right there. I might get splashed by some water here, or not, the sprinkler is going that way. I got lucky. What's 179 here? For a flexible fuel vehicle, it's 179. Wow. It's a good price. Speed limit is 40 miles an hour, but I don't see these cars going anywhere near it right now. I'm going faster than these cars. Well, this is nice. David's Lane, Watermill Heritage Area is also the Hampton Coffee Company. The lettering kind of reminds me of Starbucks over there. cemetery over there. That's a nice looking windmill. So let me just check out where Southampton is, because I do know that it's off the highway, the downtown area. I feel like I should be there almost. Not quite.
Head southwest on New York 27 West, New York State Bicycle Route 27.
Still got 12 minutes left to go, according to Google Maps.
Continue on New York 27 West for 1 mile.
So much traffic out here. I'm glad I decided to take the train and then my bicycle. Traffic out here can get pretty heavy sometimes. Whoa, look at this. Look, there's the bus. I think that's the first bus I've seen in Suffolk County in the Hamptons. They don't come too frequently. Here's the art museum, Parish Art Museum. This thing is neat. Kind of looked like 100 from the side, but now it's like the Olympic circles. And now I see grapes. These are where all the vineyards are. Duck Walk Vineyards and also live music. I can even smell the grapes from here. Thank you. the Audi dealership of Southampton.
600 feet, continue on to New York
27A. Alright, so I go this way. No, wait, it says go straight. That's confusing, it says 27 west, but I guess 27A is another route. Place called Fresco Pizza and Deli, another one called California Closets, and Heritage Creations. I like the name of that hair salon, Heritage. Got it. All right, so now I'm officially in the village of Southampton, established in 1640. Oldest English settlement in the state of New York. There's also another place called Southampton in the UK. So go figure. There's the Southampton Fire Department to my left. Here's the Triangle Tennis Club. The Jaguar dealer. Southampton Village Motel, pretty quiet place to stay, but definitely very pricey. There's Hampton Road to my left, which goes toward the beaches, but the village is up ahead. I'm about to go into the village, have some lunch, and end the video there. And then I'll make another video of the village of Southampton. I'll visit all the beaches and the Billionaire's Lane along the coastline there. That one's called Meadow Lane. Here's the town hall of Southampton. Very impressive. Has to be if this is the oldest English settlement in New York. This is the elementary school of Southampton. Mattress firm. This is definitely the downtown area of Southampton now. And there's Starbucks, perfect purse. All right.
Destination is on the right.
Well, I'm in the downtown area now. If you enjoyed this video, biking from East Hampton to Southampton, be sure to smash that like button for me. Subscribe if you haven't already to the channel. And I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye.
Now, the door.